And I'm going to show you a way to upgrade your sound system so you can enjoy digital uncompressed music right from your iPhone or iPod Touch. It's like going from a regular engine to a turbocharged one.
The Apple iPod, a device loved by millions and hated by audiophiles because you're listening to music that has been run through lossy compression. Now that's true if you download music from the iTunes store. Apple uses what's known as AAC compression, usually at 256 kilobits per second, and on older songs, 128 kilobits per second. But if you copy your own music onto it, you don't have to use that compression. You can load uncompressed music onto your iPod, and it will play back through the iPod without any lossy data compression. Now, I just found this out myself by plugging my iPod here, and I was looking through the contents of its drive here, and I did upload some WAV files to my iTunes and copied it over to the iPod. Now, I always thought that caused it to be recompressed into AAC format when it was transferred to the iPod. But as it turns out, if you load WAV files onto your iPod, it shows up on the iPod as WAV files in totally uncompressed format here. See, WAV file, 16-bit PCM, as compared to the tracks you download from iTunes, which are AAC compressed, 256 kilobits per second. So if you load uncompressed music onto your iPod, such as WAV files, it will show up on your iPod as WAV files and be played back in its original form without being re-encoded into AAC. So that's one of the audiophile myths about iPods debunked. People will say, well, that's no good because you're listening to compressed music. Well, if you load uncompressed music onto an iPod, it will play back uncompressed. Now, the question is Apple ever going to make uncompressed music available for download through the iTunes store?
I don't think so.